We're going to look at some great things that you can do in between seasons and as you get started to develop some good feel for the water. So we're big fans of strapless paddles, obviously. And some of the points to look for if you're going to have your athletes do the strapless paddles drills is go ahead and have them use a pole buoy so that they can focus on the hands rather than worrying about keeping the hips up or kicking too much. We like to start with the eyes up position so that the eyes can actually look at the elbows to make sure that the elbows are in the right position. The goal of the elbows is to be as high in the water as possible and to not move. The other option or the other thing to look for is that the elbows are positioned in front of the shoulders. So the elbows are high and in front of the shoulders ever so slightly. But this makes it easy for the athlete to see where the elbows are, and you can see that our athlete is just dropping his elbows a little bit. So as he starts to turn his head and check them out, he knows that the elbows are going to be in the right position. So you can see right here that it looks pretty good. So the elbows are very high. Again, as he's checking to see where they are, he keeps them up, and then it's a very nice positioning at that point. We want to, again, be very cognizant that the elbows are in front of the shoulders, because now we can start to see that by keeping them in front of the shoulders, that connection through the hands, forearms, elbows, biceps, and all the way back to the lats is now activated. So this is really not just about the hands and the forearms, but is really how it connects all the way back to the lats. So really opens that area up. The other thing to look at and to pay attention to is making sure that the athlete isn't just pressing out and back in, that the fingertips are constantly below the wrists. So we'd really like to have the elbow up a little bit higher and the fingers down a little bit more than this. But as he's learning this, this was the first day he ever did this, we notice that the paddle is spacing out a little bit too much. So this is not as effective as making sure that the paddle is positioned more in a downward position so that as it sweeps in and back, it's going to push the water backwards rather than just push it directly out to the side. So this is something to be avoided, which again, at the beginning of it, is why it's good to have the athlete's eyes up so that they can see a little bit more of what they're doing. Now, as we move forward to one of the next drills, which we like is dog dig freestyle or dog dig with strapless paddles, we really start to see the connection through the lats. So from the fingers, through the forearms, elbows, biceps, triceps, and back to the lats. So to really make that connection, we start to see that it does develop more of a natural swimming type of position that we want. And we really want to see this connection and the lats pop. So one of the great things about using strapless paddles is that there is a constant connection required. And so the athlete always has to have that pressure on the palms. And you'll even see that here as he sweeps back forward, he's doing a good job of not grabbing the paddles. So this teaches also a soft touch and just a little bit of pressure as he moves forward. But again, the real key here is connecting right back through the lats and making sure that those, now we really see the fingertips down, the elbow high, really close to the surface. So he did a great job, especially for the first day. And we've got a lot more strapless sculling drills that we're going to be putting on the website. So we encourage you to come on over there. And in the next week or so, we'll start posting those.